The fifth and last article of faith is the kesh, meaning hair, and refers to the uncut hair and beard of a Sikh. Avoid forcibly cutting, trimming, or pulling any part of a Sikh's hair or beard. Sikh men groom their hair into a topknot. Additionally, Sikh men either groom their beard and tuck it under the chin, or choose to leave it open and flowing.
The turban is extremely significant for Sikhs because it's an integral part of Sikh identity. It distinguishes Sikh men, and it represents honor and dignity.
The turban is mandatory for a practicing Sikh male and optional for a female. However, those women who do choose to wear the turban have integrated it as part of their identity.
For Sikh boys, they typically wear what we call a patka. It's essentially a square piece of cloth, and it's used as a head covering. Sikh girls don't have something like that, so you will see Sikh boys are distinguishable from the crowd.
Patkas and turbans both come in various different styles and colors that reflect a personal preference.
The turban is a long piece of cloth, ranging in length from 18 to 24 feet. It is not a hat or a cap that can be removed and put on casually. The turban is prepared and wrapped around the head every day and can take from 7 to 15 minutes to tie. Sikhs keep their head covered at all times. In public, the head is covered with the turban, while at home, the head is covered with a smaller under turban. Asking a Sikh to remove his or her turban in public is akin to a strip search. Public searches of the turban should be avoided. Avoid indiscriminate touching of a Sikh's turban, head, or hair. Avoid forcibly removing the turban of a Sikh. Airport security screening protocols may be different from security screening at other facilities. Sometimes a passenger may still be required to undergo additional screening for other prohibited items. If a removal or search of a Sikh's turban is necessary, explain why. If possible, have an officer of the same gender as the Sikh individual bring the person to a private location and ask them to remove their turban themselves. If the turban must be removed, provide a piece of cloth to cover the head. A Sikh communal place of worship is called a gurdwara, and it varies in architecture from large and elaborate to small and simple. Gurdwaras can be readily identified by a triangular orange flag on the property. Inside are a number of functional areas, such as a congregational hall, community kitchen, eating area, and a place for Sunday school. The Sikh scripture is called the Guru Granth Sahib. This sacred text is the Sikh's eternal living guru and is regarded with utmost reverence. Sikhs remove their shoes and cover their heads before entering the congregational hall and community kitchen. Tobacco or alcohol products of any kind are prohibited from the Gurdwara property. When visiting a Sikh place of worship, be respectful of these Sikh sensibilities. Unless there are overriding safety and security concerns, follow this protocol should you visit a Gurdwara. However, in circumstances where removal of shoes and covering of head is not possible, ask about another meeting location. If investigating a burglary or vandalism of a Sikh American home, be aware that many Sikh homes also have a room set aside for prayer, where they keep the Guru Granth Sahib. Exhibit the same respect for this place as you would for the communal place of worship. Should you need to enter this room, remove your shoes and cover your head.
Punjabi is the native language for Sikhs. Most Sikhs speak Punjabi as well as English. Sikhs who don't speak English may require assistance, and the best thing to do is contact the Sikh American community to provide translation services for those that are not fluent in English.
Now that you have a basic awareness and knowledge about Sikhs, let's take a moment to conclude and review some highlights of this presentation. As stated earlier, officer safety is paramount. These recommendations are for non-emergency and non-crisis situations only. Departments are encouraged to have discussions about the appropriate handling of religious articles of faith. The five articles of faith and the turban are mandated religious items that are fundamental to a Sikh's identity. When interacting with Sikh Americans, be respectful and sensitive to these Sikh articles of faith. If you have a reason to confiscate any of the five articles of faith or the turban, handle them with respect and store them in a safe and clean place. The turban is an integral part of a Sikh's identity. If removal of the turban is necessary, explain the reason and have the person remove the turban him or herself in a private room. If you take a Sikh into custody and need to confiscate the turban, provide a piece of cloth to cover the head. It is important to note that not all Sikhs wear the kirpan. However, if you have a reason to inspect the kirpan, respectfully ask for it to be shown. If confiscating the kirpan is necessary, explain why and store it in a clean place. In a federal facility, refer to your office's standard operating procedure for further guidance regarding the kirpan. If you are a police officer, review your department's policies for handling of the kirpan. Avoid forcibly cutting, trimming, or pulling any part of a Sikh's hair or beard. Avoid forcibly removing the kara. Some Sikhs may have worn it for many years, and so removal may not be possible. When entering a Sikh gurdwara, consult with officials of the gurdwara about specific areas where removal of shoes and head covering may not be necessary. Maintain respect for the Sikh scripture, the Guru Granth Sahib. Avoid touching the scripture.
You know, we're often asked, what relevance does cultural competency have to do with law enforcement? And the reality of that is that misconceptions can lead to a lot of circumstances that are law enforcement oriented. That it sounds non-traditional, it sounds like it's not a law enforcement issue. But look around us and you have language issues that could lead to officer safety problems. You have visual issues where people look different. You have worship issues where we have a multitude of houses of worship of different kinds in this country and county now. And we all live together remarkably well, but we know remarkably little about each other. The more we know about each other, the safer we're going to be around each other, the more we're going to appreciate ourselves, the similarities and the differences, and understand that we're mostly the same.
Police officers have an expectation that people in their community will have an understanding of the job that they do every day. As police leaders, we should have an expectation that law enforcement officers in our communities understand the cultures of the people that they serve.